Hereby constitute this assembly as a legal congregation of the University of Pretoria. During this assembly, diplomas will be awarded on and conferred upon the graduates whose names who appear in the program. Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats. Ladies and gentlemen, I invite you to join us in silent prayer or meditation to give thanks for the achievements of our students who graduate this morning. Thank you. Graduates, ladies and gentlemen, in my capacity as Vice Chancellor and Principal of the University of Pretoria, I am delighted to welcome you to the very first of the university's 2018 graduation ceremonies. A very warm welcome to all our diplomates, their families, and your friends who are here to support and celebrate with you. I also wish to acknowledge the presence of the Dean of the Gordon Institute of Business Science, Gibs, Professor Nicola Klein, the faculty members of Gibs who are here to support you at your moment of celebration, and also officiating at this ceremony is Dr. Elmarie Liebenberg, Deputy Director of the University's Department of Student Enrollment and Administration, and I'm delighted to have present as well a representative of the Student Representative Council of the University, Ms. Machado. Ladies and gentlemen, as I indicated, this is the first of our autumn series of graduations. This autumn, we will convene a total of 32 graduation ceremonies in this venue. While we may have several graduation ceremonies, each one is unique, distinctive, and different. And for that reason, there are very few other official duties that I have that give me as much joy as a graduation ceremony. For me, it's the culmination of what the university stands for, our core academic mission. Graduation as a ceremony in some countries is known as convocation, commencement, and is believed to have started in the 12th century. It was introduced by scholastic monks who wore robes during the entire graduation ceremony. And of course, since the 12th century, it has changed since. And of course, we're pleased that there have been changes. The procedures and the traditions surrounding graduation ceremonies today differ around the world. But what we all have in common is that universities across the world convene for an occasion where qualifications are conferred and academic excellence is celebrated. In South Africa, the prestige and stature of graduation ceremonies is such that many preschools nowadays also have graduation ceremonies. At this university, it's become a tradition that our first graduation is in fact a Gibbs graduation. And one of the reasons is that Gibbs is a very special and distinctive part of the University of Pretoria. But in addition to Gibbs, we have 9 faculties across the institution. And it might not be known to you, but this university, the University of Pretoria, introduced the very first MBA program in South Africa after the end of World War II. And at that time, it was also the very first across the continent of Africa. Of course now, Gibbs is no longer delivered here at the Pretoria campus, but exclusively at Gibbs, our Johannesburg campus. And it has risen to new levels of prestige and impact. For example, in the 2017 Financial Mail Annual Survey, Gibbs was ranked the most reputable MBA among employers. with many other accolades. The Gibbs Postgraduate Diploma in Business Administration, the PDBA, was introduced more recently, and it responds to the changing needs in the world of business. It is aimed at fast-tracking high-potential individuals, namely you, in the early stages of your management careers to further heights in the world of business. In completing a Gibbs qualification, you have been exposed to a highly relevant curriculum that is tailored to give you an understanding of how to successfully run a department or a division or some strategic function within your organization. We know that today's employees experience rapid mobility and expect to do so. There are high expectations regarding rewards and job satisfaction. We trust that with your postgraduate diploma being conferred today, you have been equipped with knowledge, tools, and skills that will position you well to fast-track you in the world of work. Your achievement that we celebrate today is testimony that you have embraced the concept of lifelong learning. In other words, you have made a commitment to ensuring that you maintain the ongoing ability to develop new skills and to be responsive in the face of a rapidly changing world. I believe that your acquisition of this qualification is very timely, as this is a momentous time for us in South Africa, a time that many analysts have signaled as a new dawn for the national economy, bringing better prospects of growth and with it an expansion of opportunities. Through hard work and personal sacrifice, you have ensured that you are well equipped to contribute to a nation with expanding opportunities. Your presence here today is proof that you have met the highest standards of quality and excellence. And for that, I wish to give credit to the Dean and her team for upholding those standards. Congratulations. To all our diplomats sitting before me, today is the time we celebrate your success. And we also express our appreciation to those who have supported you throughout your journey. This is the time for you to be proud. This is the time for you to be joyful. I expect to see smiles on your faces. You're looking all very serious. This is the time to bask in the pride of your accomplishment. This is the time to look forward to a new dawn, to a world of expanding opportunities. Congratulations on your achievement. I now wish to invite you to smile and enjoy the ceremony with us. And I request the Dean, Professor Klein, to introduce to me the candidates present whose names appear in the program.
Vice Chancellor and Principal, the following candidates have complied with all the requirements for the postgraduate diploma in general management. Mohamed Reza Afshariam Chelo. James Anafi. Crystal Anamalai. Sarushka Acha. Charlene Bailey. Mm-hmm.
Oluwafun Melayo Bankole. Henry Bunches. Ndebasizi Banze. Steffi Barandereka Nineza. Tomislav Batev. Hannes Becker. Siape Bochatsu. Niliswa Boy. The PG DIP General Management with distinction, Eric Bornman. Marnus Boerter. David Bretzka. Melissa Bryant. Dinesh Baldu. Mankoba Tele. Tapiwa Chatora. Thashni Chetty. Christos Constantino. Emmanuel Cumbias. Carlos de Almeida. Sandra de Sousa. Zahir Dudat. The Postgraduate General Management with distinctions and the Best Student in Operations Management, Ashton Drummond. Trevor Dunn. Dwayne Edwards. Jonathan Ellis. Paul Eloff. Johan Esterhuizen. Tembelani Rancho. Ilse G. van Pittiersberg. Nadia Gossman. Lauren Hayworth. Maiteng Klalele. Janine Holin. Susara Homan. Mpo Hoti. Avesh Inderjeet. Justin Jax. Jason Yannicka. Victor Janssen van Rensburg. Martin Jaravaza. Ashley Jomath. The Postgraduate Diploma General Management with Distinction, Rhys Johnston. Jacobus Jonker. Nizelle Jabert. The Postgraduate Diploma General Management with Distinction, Adam Kara. Well done. Kutluano Kali. Shafaraz Khan. Regina Kumalo. The best student for the subject analytical tools and techniques, Tabile Kuzwayo. Tanusha Kirsten. Vihan Koch. Lisha Kuber. Matlodi Letiane. Johannes Lombard. Kenneth Mabasa. You go there. Tebogo Mabitsela. Saul Machingauta. Nonkululeko Madiba. Ntombi Futi Madisha. Tato Mahasa. Mahlako Mahapa. Recibi Matlomocha. Faisal Mohammed. Shefohatso Makofane. Trifosa Malazzi. Mahlame Mamshika. You go around. Good morning. Do you have a card for me? Do you want to just tell me your name? Real Mare. Masakoane Marakabe. Olebogeng Marakala. Mandla Masangane. Dimakatso Masedi. Tungai Mashava. Tafadzwa Matambo. Ntola Matuka. Amy Milner. Wakile Makonza.
I'm very well, Unati.
Unati Nkiva.
You go there.
Nomaklube Ngomezulu. Mampalelwa Modiba.
Thank you, Mampalelwa. Good morning. Right, I need to get your name right.
Soraya Mohammadia Tederesi.
Good morning.
Matthew Mayer. Kapalelo Mokitli. Mpolokeng Mokone. Paul Malloy. Veronica Malloy. Prevanya Mudli. Mahoane Moswane. Johannes Mostert. Inosius Mpambo. Calvin Mundry. Anandran Munilal. Shantanu Nega. Alton Naidu. Dion Naidu. Narayan Naidu.
One more.
Roderick Naidu. Not a Naidu. Motsabi Ndebele. Ernest and Lovu.
Good morning, welcome.
Julius Ngobo. Joyce Nguira.
Good morning, welcome.
Lungelo Nomvalo.
Thanks. Good morning.
The PG DIP General Management with distinction, Dora Nchabele.
Good morning.
Nancy Obor. Agnes O'Neill.
Good morning. Welcome. Can I have that one? Thank you.
Alex Opoku Yeboah.
Good morning. Welcome.
Altaf Osman. The Postgraduate Diploma General Management with Distinction for the Best Student in Human Resources Strategy and the Best Student in Marketing, Kurusha Padiachi. Okay. Migeshni Palani. Brett Pampara. Suresh Patel. Neha Patel Manga. Renelle Patha. Amochelang Pefo. Lebohang Pilane. Vice Chancellor and Principal, this is a gentleman who has put this whole graduation together, so I'm delighted to be welcoming him here today, Praveshan Pillay. Riyasha Pillay. Sherry Lee Pillay.
Good morning.
Vireshan Pillay. Tandiwe Pino.
Morning, welcome.
Storm Potts. Milani Ramasamy. Refilwe Ramokhase.
Is it Ramrutan?
Desmond Ramrutan. Varun Rao. Naveen Reddy. Hermanus Riedlinghuis. Just wait for a second. Derek Ritchie. Enva Rose. Janice Sambaza. Jason Sanders Flaherty. Lindy Schult. Chuene Setati. Karima Shah. Shahram Shariatzadeh Sigarudi. Postgraduate Diploma General Management with Distinction and the Best Student in Organizational Development and Transformation, Tyron Sharnock. Okay. Bonisiwe Shongwe. Ndileka Shuenyane. Bontle Sibiya. Jessica Singh. Shekha Singh. With a prize for the best student in management accounting, Yateen Singh. Lucas Sitimbiso. Dominic Smith. Arish Sukdio. Amore Swanepoel. Craig Swanepoel. Nizan Swat. Muhammad Tabassum. You go around there. Peter Taliart. Misha Tessendorf. Chavo Temani. Unati Tosacho. Molepane Chechla. Rebecca Tosane. Wesley van den Heerfer. Armand van der Merwe. Mornay van der Westhuizen. Adrian Velez. Charlotte Fenter. Jacobus Fenter.
Good morning, welcome.
The Postgraduate Diploma in General Management with Distinction and the best student in microeconomics, prices and markets, Candace Walls. Tabang Vesi. Aldane White. There you go. Valerie Wiggett.
Good morning and welcome.
Michelle Wood. Akhil Woodrudge. Eddie Xavier. Marion Zeller.
How are you today? I'm very good, thanks, Muzi.
Muziwake Zim. Nonjabulo Zondi.
Lungile Zulu. Nokwanda Zungu. Fanele Zwane. Katlego Nisi. Pusiletso Ntene.
Vice Chancellor, I have the honour to present a candidate for the PG Dip in Business Administration, Etienne Boyson. We continue with the Postgraduate Diploma in Business Administration, Alea Bucci. Vice Chancellor and Principal, the following candidates have complied with all the requirements for the Postgraduate Diploma in Business Studies. Paula Buchel. We're back to the Postgraduate Diploma in Business Administration, Siziwe Dube. And Craig Golding. Given Hapadziwe.
Thank you.
Michloti Masuleke. Agnes Ruoro.
Well done for being here.
Teresa Vermeulen. Marilyn White.
Vice Chancellor and Principal, that concludes my requests for you to confer diplomas. I would now like to ask you if I could please introduce the candidate receiving the top award for the Postgraduate Diploma in General Management. As Chancellor and Principal, it gives me great pleasure to announce that the winner, the Gibbs Top PG Dip GM Graduate for Outstanding Academic Achievement throughout the Postgraduate Diploma Program in 2017, is Candace Walls.
Ladies and gentlemen, I now invite all of us to congratulate and to demonstrate our joy in the achievements of the students who have graduated this morning. I trust that during the time that you've spent at Gibbs, you've accumulated positive memories, you have formed friendships and networks that will last a lifetime and will go with you in your future careers. And very importantly in today's world, that you've acquired values and a work ethic that will serve you well in your future. With a qualification from the University of Pretoria's Gordon Institute of Business Science, we are confident that you will be well positioned to realize your career aspirations, whatever they might be. But I do, and I am aware, and I know from my own experience, that no person is an island. It's an oft-quoted phrase, because whatever we achieve as individuals is also due to those who support us. So I now wish to invite our graduates this morning to demonstrate their appreciation to those who have supported you throughout your journey at Gibbs. I now wish to invite the Dean, Professor Nicola Klein, to address the audience. Professor Klein.
Vice Chancellor and Principal, thank you for the opportunity. I'm aware this doesn't get extended on all graduations, but it's an absolute pleasure to be saying a few brief words on this auspicious occasion. Graduates, I'm always sad when I'm standing here handing out the names that I don't get to clap, so I was able to give a good clap there, but it really is an honor to formally congratulate you on achieving your qualifications today. I know that many of you continue as our students on further degrees, but I do support the Vice Chancellor and Principal wholeheartedly to say, please, take some time, feel the joy. Special occasions, especially graduations, I think are opportunities for us also to celebrate in the moment, but to look backwards and to look forwards. And I am often reminded of the words of our great leader, Nelson Mandela, when he said, "I've discovered the secret that after climbing a great hill, one only finds that there are many more hills to climb. I've taken a moment here to rest, to steal a view of the glorious vista that surrounds me, to look back on the distance that I've come. But I can only rest for a moment, for with freedom come responsibilities, and I dare not linger. My long walk is not ended." So whilst we celebrate in the moment and you look at the vista, I ask us to think a little about the fact that we each have to walk our own long walk. And the achievement of your qualification signals a noteworthy climb in your walk, another one in the process. But I trust that despite the aches and pains that accompany any challenging climb, you'll look back on this as a significant, enabling experience. But it is a great hill. And the questions must be asked are, what will your next hills be? And how will you choose to climb them? I mentioned looking back. When I studied at business school in the 1990s, the role models that were meant to inform our choice of great hills to climb were fairly singular. A large proportion of them were white, male, and American. And most of them were awarded status because they'd built large companies and made their shareholders rich. My MBA was characterized by a lot of talk of corporate rating, charismatic leadership, and competitive advantage. Our humanistic landscape shifts far faster than the glorious hills and valleys of nature that, provided we allow them as humankind, will remain long after our demise. And the slavish following of captains of industry, in my time, led by a business media that was largely unresponsive to the voices of its stakeholders, beyond shareholders, and occasionally customers, that was the focus when I was at business school, has given way to a piercing of the corporate veil that shows deep vulnerability to profound technological shifts on one hand, and the need for a far more finely tuned awareness of the impact of business on humanity on the other. To be successful going forward, we must all navigate both. You've walked in and out of the campus at Gibbs many times, and in the flurry of meetings, syndicates, more food, lectures, examinations, the mission written on many walls on the campus may have become wallpaper. As you take time to celebrate before identifying your next hill, great, small, I want to remind you of what I believe to be the two most important words in that mission to be. Responsible performance. Responsible performance. The past few months have provided us with case studies of corporates and other organizations that have demonstrated the antithesis of responsible performance. Our faculty are in the process of writing up case studies on the behavior of leaders and employees at KPMG, McKinsey, and SEDmany, to mention a few, that are already being incorporated into our curricula as key reminders to learn and improve. Sadly, the queue of companies and their leaders that violate the tenets of responsible business is not becoming shorter. I've little doubt that we'll be seeking to understand the learnings from problems that are playing out as organizations as we speak, like Grant Thornton, Imperial, and a number of the property management companies.
Some fingers have been pointed at business schools. Questions have been asked about the role we play in shaping the behavior of our graduates. And whilst we can quantify the metrics that have been historically tracked as the vanguard of business school success, employment, career paths, and increased earnings being examples, I really only have two questions that, if well answered, will give us a deep sense of pride that we have played a small role in enabling your progress. Firstly, did your Gibbs journey enable you to learn faster? Because it's actually less about what we taught and what you now know than about how well you developed the skills to learn. The knowledge you acquired on your diplomas has a half-life, but the meta skill of learning to learn will stand you in great stead for an era in which technology and other socio-political drivers will profoundly redefine the performance of business in the eyes of its multiple stakeholders. Secondly, do you leave with a qualification, we hope you never leave Gibbs, that stands for a honed moral compass and a heightened awareness of how your actions in business aid or hinder the well-being of humanity? Because frankly, if we ramp up a share price tomorrow but diminish the legacy we leave for multiple stakeholders as well as future generations, we've failed. So as we conclude our proceedings today, I look back to applaud your climb. In looking forward, my first ask of you as Gibbs alumni is to hold those precious two words, in our mission, close to your head, your heart, and your hands as you select and navigate your next mountain. For I believe that these are the criteria against which we will ultimately define our success as a school and your success as our alumni going forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Klein. I now also wish to invite all of us to express our appreciation to the Dean and her excellent team who have contributed, I'm sure, to your achievement, which we celebrate this morning. Thank you, Professor Klein. Ladies and gentlemen, we've now come to the end of the formal celebration. But before we close, I do wish to invite all of you who are present this morning to some refreshments in the marquee immediately outside of this venue. I now kindly request you to stand for the singing of the national anthem and then to remain standing until the assembly has been dissolved and the academic procession has left the auditorium. In case you need it, the words of the national anthem are printed on the inside back cover of the program. May I invite everyone to rise, please?
Oh,
By the powers vested in me, I hereby dissolve this assembly of the University of Pretoria.